Hello friends, do you want to improve your English? We all know that we need to improve our roots to get good fruits. So, to get good fruits of English, we are now going to learn the roots of English. Yes, we are now going to learn tenses today. These are the main fundamental pillar for speaking and writing correct English. And you must learn them properly. Have you ever considered them learning and thought that they are hard to learn or grasp and boring too? Then this video has a lot for you which will make you feel that tenses are much easier to learn and in the most easiest way possible. So without a further go, let's get started. What exactly is a tense? Tense is a form a verb takes to show the time it happened. It actually describes when any action happened with respect to time. Now, the time the action took could be past, present, or future. Consider this timeline. The circle represents the present time. The line left to the circle is the time which has already passed, and the line right to the circle is the future time. Please understand this timeline properly as we are going to use this timeline for understanding when any action took place with respect to time. Now, as time could be past, present, or future, so tenses are divided mainly into three types: past tense, present tense, and future tense. Now, each of these three types have four subtypes: simple, continuous, perfect, and perfect continuous. You can consider it as a family tree where grandfather tense is having three children: past, present, and future. And each parent is having four sons with the same name: simple, continuous, perfect, and perfect continuous. Binding them all becomes 12 siblings. So, we are going to learn each of them at a time. Before that, we need to revise the forms of verb. Verbs are mainly divided into 5 forms, which are base form, we will denote it as V1, past form, we will denote it as V2, past participle, we will denote it as V3, SES form, we will denote it as VSES, and ING form, we will denote it as VING. Let's look into an example of verb play. The base form of play is play, in the past form it is played, and in the past participle it is played. In the SES form it is plays, and in ING form it is playing. Let's look into one more example. Go in the base form is go, past form it is went, in the past participle form it is gone, and in SES form it is goes, and in ING form it is going. Now that you are clear with the verb form, let's dive into the tenses. First, we will look into perfect tenses now. Present perfect tense. It refers to an action that began in the past and is still true in the present. Or it also refers to an action that happened in the past but time is not specified. Structure of it is subject plus have or has plus verb's third form plus object. Let's look into an example of action that happened in the past and still true. I have played football a lot this way. Let's look into the timeline for it. The action of playing has started in the past and is still true in the present moment. That is, I am still playing football. Now, let's look into an example of finished action without any time declared. I have finished my homework. Here, we are getting to know that the homework is done. But the time is not specified when exactly the homework was done. So, in the timeline, it will look like this. You may think it is a simple past, but here, time is not known. While in the simple past, we know the time when the event was completed. Please remember this difference. From two timelines, we understood the two usage of present perfect tense. Let's look into the next one. Past perfect tense. It refers to an action that completed before any other action in the past. Structure of past perfect tense is subject plus had plus verb's third form plus object. For example, I had played football before you came. So, one action of playing was already completed before another action in the past. In the timeline, it will look like this. On the left hand side, an action of playing is already completed with respect to another action came. I hope you are clear with past perfect tense. Let's look into the next tense. Future perfect tense. It refers to an action that will happen before any another event in the future. Here, we are comparing two events in the future. Structure of it is subject plus will have plus verb's third form plus object. For example, I will have played football by the time you arrive. So, my action of playing will be already completed before the action of your arriving. In the timeline, it will look like this. On the right hand side, an action of playing will be completed by the time another action of your arriving comes. So, here, comparison of two future events is happening. So now, we have covered all the perfect tenses.